Hi, Floss Tube. This is Minnie from All X's. I don't really have a whole lot to show today. I have, you know, a few whips. I have a little bit of a haul. What else? I've got my notes over here, so a couple things I just wanted to show you today, and I didn't want it for it to be, you know, a month or whatever between videos, so I decided I would do a little short one today. Now, you saw my whip in the last video. This is the Connie G stitch along that I had been working on. I haven't got that much farther on it since the last time. I worked on some of the little gold motifs is where I left off. Here's my needle still there. But I didn't get much more stitched on that one because I stopped to work on the Snowflower Diaries month to month stitch along from last year, and I started on March, and this is as far as I got on it. I need March up there and some border and a few more things, but this is as far as I've gotten on that one. Okay, now what I really wanted to show you is I talked about this chart last time. Excuse me. The 2017 Linen and Threads Mystery Sampler, Part 1, January 2017. Okay, so they've come out with Part 2. That's the band for Part 2. And I decided I changed my fabric again. I know I told you about a 18 count Aida that I was going to do it on, but I ended up going to Stitch Night at in Stitches, my local LNS, and I saw another stitcher who had started hers, and she was stitching on a 32 count. Excuse me. Coffee. Anyway, she was stitching on a 32 count linen, I believe. And I loved it. It was in a cream-like color. So, I decided that I was going to go ahead and purchase some more fabric. Now, let me show you my colors that I decided on. I don't know if I showed them to you last time or not. I don't know if I had chosen them yet. But the first one is 4210. It's DMC 4210. And it's a variegated. And it goes from a dark, you know, deep red to a bright red. The second one is 4066. It's also DMC, and it goes from a light green to a darker green. There's a bird in here. I decided it's going to be a bluebird, but it's not just a plain bluebird. I chose 4240, DMC 4240, which is a dark blue, but it also has a little purple in it, so that I liked. Now, there is in the chart, you can decide whether you want to use one color, multiple colors, whatever. and you can stitch whichever part you want in whatever color you want. So there's a part down here in this chart at the bottom, right between those birds, that a friend of mine at Stitch Night, we were looking at it, and it looks like a pot of some sort that the flower, you know, the big flowers are sitting in. So that's what I decided. It was going to be a pot. And I decided to use 420, DMC 420. It's a kind of a type of a brownish gold, like brass almost. So copper brass. So that's my pot. Now, I started on this on the 2nd of February. And so here is my whip. This is as far as I've gotten. As you can see, the big red flowers, there's a variegation in those. You can see the variegation in the green stem portion and leaves, and the brass at the bottom for the pots. So, this is what I have been actually working on, and I'm having such a good time. I love working on this. And this is on a ivory, 32 count ivory Joblin, and I'm loving it. I'm really loving it. Hopefully by the end of the month I'll have at least that first bay. I'll at least have January finished and part of maybe February, hopefully, if something else doesn't catch my eye. Or so, all right, so now I've got a little, see, that's what I'm saying, that's all the stitching I've actually done since my last video update. But I did get a little bit of haul. Now, this is January's February's even week, fabric of the month. And mine is a 28 count Lugano. And this is evergreen. I don't know if you can see. That's pretty good. But isn't that pretty? I don't know what I'm going to stitch on it. There we go. I don't know what I'm going to stitch on it, but I love it. This is a Lugano. And it's very easy to stitch on. But I like that. That's Under the Sea Fabrics. Very pretty. Okay. Okay. Now, I want to show you some charts. Well, not the charts, but pictures of charts. That I have. Well, they're actually, some of them are in magazines. They're in the cross-stitch collection magazines. Not cross-stitch collection. Yeah, collections. The one that's going out of business. The one who has finished production of their magazines. This is from the last. This one I thought, oh, this is adorable. I had to have it. So what I did was I purchased it as a digital copy, just in case I don't get to Barnes and Noble and or they don't have them or whatever. I get the magazine digitally, but I love the paper magazines. Now they used to put the big fold-in charts, the free charts at the end of the book magazines. And if you got a digital copy of the magazine, you didn't get the free chart. After a while, they started this the last few editions. But this is the your free fold out chart. It's not fold out. But this, I love this. This is National Treasures Giant Chart. And I guess it's the name of his National Treasures. But it's the little ladies from different countries. Isn't that just adorable? I love that. I really love that. I love that. I love the, I don't know, I've always liked the different, like, you know, styles and things from different countries and different parts of the world and stuff. And this one really, I saw that and I'm like, oh yes, got to have that issue. So, don't know when I'm going to start it, but I've got it nonetheless. So, got that one. Now, like I said, these are all in the magazine. And there's a couple of them that I've just got to show you a picture of. And I'll do this so you won't be able to see the chart. But isn't that pretty? I thought that was just gorgeous. That one, and then this green one. Oh, beautiful. Love it. Like I said, I don't know when I'm going to start these. There's two more. There's another one that's, it's shaped like the apple. It's got a, I guess maybe a cup of pineapple cider and an apple pie. And, but these look like cherries on this tree. But it's just a chart, it's not a picture. So I want to show the chart. And let's see, then there's another one that has mist and melon fruitfulness. And it's got pictures of a tree and it's really pretty. These are really, really pretty. So, they're by Amanda Butler, and they're in the Cross Stitch Collection September 2016 issue. So, if you have that one, go back and check it out. Right now, they're still on, you can still buy them, download them as digital magazines. I don't know how long that's going to stay up there, though. This one is a house of the month. Let me see, do I have a picture? The only picture I have is this one, and it really doesn't show a whole lot. Oh, well, that's just the colors. Okay, but they're different. This one is by Shannon, itchy nose. I can't remember her name. I'll find it and put it in below. I thought I had wrote everything down because I'm terrible at remembering names and stuff. So, but anyway, it's beautiful charts. If you like, you know, stitching houses. I'm not that crazy about them, but I've just made do these. They're small, so it's not, you know, going to take me forever. This one is another one. This one is by Maria Diaz, and I just love this. It's, I guess you could use it as a wedding sampler or, you know, for an anniversary. But it's just two hands. Can you see that? I'll take it out. Yep, it's just two hands. Holding hands. I think that's really nice. So, I got that just in case. I wanted to make another wedding sampler or anniversary sampler for my husband and me. Or if I decide to make one for someone else, I have a pattern. Okay, this one, Joan Austin fans will love it. This is another one from, let me see. Here is a picture. It's old, but make noises. It's this one. I mean, this is really nice. This could be a wedding sampler. If you know, you could change up the hair or, you know, the coloring of their clothing and make them to a wedding sampler. But this is also in the cross stitch collection, which is his month. Let's see, it has. Doesn't have the month on here, but it's on the I have to look that one up. It's by Shannon Wasislav. That's her name. W-A-S-I-L-L-I-E-F-F. I knew her name was on here somewhere. And I have to, but it's cross stitch collection. I'm not sure which edition it was. So I have to put that one down below also. Here is a carousel. This is Doreen Jones. Now this is going to be a very, very small picture because I don't want to show her chart. But it's a carousel. Okay. That's Doreen Jones. That is in Cross Stitch Collection May of 2016. Let's see, I went back and I looked at all the charts, the magazines, and decided I was going to download, I was going to buy which issues I wanted to buy, and so I downloaded the charts that I was most interested in. Here's one. I did buy this issue. This is the November 2016 cross stitch collection issue, and it was the first part of this. This is the giant pullout chart, and this is the first part of it. So, you know, I won't open it all the way up for you to see the chart, but you see this is, pull this out, and this is the first half. And I'll show you, here's the picture of the whole thing. Yeah. It's like the cut-through house, you know, it shows inside, and it's got who's in the house, they've got, oh, actually it has, couldn't see it too well. Downstairs in the living room there, well, there's got people in there, the children and the parents are in bed, and Santa's in the living room. So, I got the December issue, downloaded the December issue, that way I'd have the whole chart if I ever decided to stitch that. But now I've got the whole thing. And last but not least, this, I found this online. Now, I have all my notes written here on the front of the page, so that way I know what to. It's from DMC. It's actually a free chart, and it's DMC, but it's DMC Portugal. and all of the blog, you know, from DMC, it's in Portuguese. Now, you can have Google translate it for you, but the pictures are all the same. This is, it was someone on Cross Stitch Mania. Yeah, Stitch Mania. Shared this. Ruth Reed shared Stitching the Night Away post of Travel Through Europe free pattern sale from DMC Portugal. And so they've given the first part. Sorry. They've given the first, the chart for the first part. And the countries, the cities that they're showing is Amsterdam, which was the first one, Copenhagen, Moscow, London, Brussels, Berlin, Paris, Bern. I'm not sure where that is. Looks like it's in the Swiss Alps. Vienna, Lisbon, Madrid, and Rome. But I think that is so cute. And you can arrange it. I guess you can arrange them any way you'd like. Like everybody's doing the postcards from around the world. This is DMC Portugal, and they're offering this one for free. So, like I said, you can go to, I'll put the link down in the description. And I'm not sure that you give them your email. You have to get, you know, put your email address in there, and they'll send it to you in an email. And I'm not sure if they'll automatically send, you know, the second part, or if you have to go back to the site, but, you know, they're on a monthly deal. So, I would assume, since this started, I believe this started, I'm assuming it started in February. But it started with, the first one was Amsterdam, which is the only one that they sent that's available. So, I'm not sure, like I said, I'm not sure if you'll get the second, you know, you'll get the each month automatically, or if you have to go back, go there and down, you know, request it. But I think they're so cute. From what I get from their page, the stitch count on, I guess, the whole thing is 155 by 122. And that would cover 12 of the cities. I guess if you wanted to, you know, stitch them all on piece. And now it doesn't tell how many spaces between, you know, that you, if you want to put, there's no borders on the individual cities. Or is it? Well, there's a small, on the chart. On the chart, there is a small, there's a line on there. I guess you can put a little border between them if you want. But you can also, it makes it easier to count how many spaces between, you know, one picture and the next. So it's very nice, a very good chart. It's color chart, colors, and it has the symbols. So I'm going to collect those if I don't stitch them. I'm going to collect them. Who knows, I might stitch them. I'm a little different. I don't like following every, so this one is different. This isn't plum, what is it? Pumpkin patch, pumpkin, I'm sorry, Frosted Pumpkin or Clouds Factory. This isn't there. This is from DMC, and it's a freebie. So if I want to go from city to city, then I can do this for free. So that's me. All right, so that is my haul. Let's see. I did want to do a little, just one, you know, a little shout out to a couple of friends of mine. Oh, at least I feel like they're friends of mine. Abby Bella Stitch, I don't know any more than anybody else knows about her reasoning for, you know, leaving social media. It's personal, I'm assuming, because she didn't tell anybody. So I respect that. And I just wish her the best. And whatever she's going through, I hope she gets through it quickly. And come back to making videos and business on Facebook. So I wish her the best. And also to my friend Danielle. Love you, Danielle. I wish you the best. I'm praying for you. I know you can, you get this, you know. And I found a couple pieces that I'm going to turn into needle minders. I do that for myself. I love making my own. But these are so cute. They're owls. These just the little charms. My birthstone is pearl, and this is close to pearl, so that one is going to be mine. Well, they'll all be mine, but definitely that owl. And this is a shout out to McKenna and her friend Pepe. Pepe in Diamonds. Now, I love that one. Pepe in Diamonds. Yes, I'm going to put a magnet on the back of the head, and this will also be a needle minder. A blingy Pepe. Okay. Let's see. Sorry about that. I almost knocked over it had fallen over. So I had to set up everything. I had to set my tripod and iPad and everything back up. So sorry about that. Like I said, I just wanted to make a little short video. I think if I make the short ones maybe more frequently instead of trying to wait a long time. But I'm going now to make some of those little X's, you know, the little X's. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.